Hi, my name is Patrick Dupre Quigley, and I am very excited to lead the music of the Baroque Orchestra in a program of music dedicated to the concept of heroism. Our show opens with a collaboration between the music of the Baroque Orchestra and the South Chicago Dance Theater.
Oh, in music of the Baroque, we love to collaborate from time to time with different organizations. Our music comes from 3-4 centuries ago. So in terms of making it relevant and alive in the Chicago of today, we usually collaborate with another organization. And we're really excited this year to collaborate with South Chicago Dance Theater. Kia Smith is their executive artistic director. We went to see her show at the Harris Theater. It was just amazing, and we felt this is a great fit for music of the Baroque.
So initially when I got the email asking about the collaboration, I was really excited because I actually love Baroque music. I grew up, my dad's a musician, so I grew up listening to music, all kinds of music. And I've listened to Bach my whole life, so just the idea of Baroque music is really exciting to me.
As the basis of our collaboration, we are using the 1612 publication Terpsichore, which is a collection of hundreds of Renaissance dances. It in effect served as both the jukebox and the muzak for early 17th century court life. This collection was compiled by the composer Michael Pretorius. Pretorius was, in essence, a very early ethnomusicologist who put together a number of dances from across the European continent into one single collection that could be used as the basis for both dancing and for music to eat and to converse and to party by.
When I heard Terpsichore, it just sounded like music that you should choreograph something to, like it means made for dancing. And what was special about it for me, I think, was doing the research on these different Baroque dances, but then thinking about how could I pull elements of those dances and kind of mix them into something more contemporary. So people felt like when they saw the choreography, it wasn't what they would expect to see. Project is different from anything else that we're doing this season or that we've done before, and that someone else gave us music to work with, which is a challenge for me as a choreographer, because in contemporary dance you usually have the flexibility to choose different things or different sounds, and so that was a challenge in a good way for me. And I think in terms of how we relate it to it, my process, I don't like to be abstract most of the time, or if it comes across as abstract, that's not always my intention. I always have a story, or it's always rooted in something. And so in researching the Baroque era, everything about King Louis XIV and being at Versailles came up. And so I was researching just day-to-day life at Versailles and King Louis and all of his romantic escapades that he had during that time. And each of the women that I read about had a very dramatic and traumatic story of they were in the king's favor and then they were out of the king's favor. It was just all very dramatic. And so for us as a company, we were able to pull from those stories, and each female dancer has a character and a narrative that they take from the beginning all the way through the end, and how they experience the dance, how they experience each other in the dance, and how they relate to the audience as well.
We're just thrilled to be on stage with such a dynamic group of young, talented dancers in this vibrant city of Chicago, and to have this chance to really, you know, mix two different worlds together is very exciting, very rewarding.
The next four pieces on the show deal with musical portrayals of heroism. The first piece, the burlesque of Don Quixote by Georg Philipp Telemann, is an onomatopoetic adventure through Cervantes's hero Don Quixote and his sidekick Sancho Panza. We hear Don Quixote at sleep and waking up. We hear him sighing for the Princess Dulcinea. He fights with windmills. His sidekick, Sancho Panza, is thrown up and down and up and down in a blanket in order to swindle him out of his money. And we finish with a portrayal of Don Quixote at sleep, where you can hear him dreaming of further galloping adventures. From there, we move on to a concerto in A major for cello by C.P.E. Bach, Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach, who is the son of Johann Sebastian Bach. The cellist, the soloist in this concerto, is the hero. This part is played by Music of the Baroque's own principal cellist, Paul Dwyer. And Paul, in the first movement, portrays a happy-go-lucky musician. But in the second movement, he is overcome by sadness. In the third movement, he is able to fight through that sadness into joy with the help of the members of the orchestra. This piece is written in what is known as the sentimental style, which has drastic shifts in mood and volume and in articulation side by side, making for some shocking moments in music. On the second half of the program, we'll start with a suite of music from Jean-Philippe Rameau's masterpiece opera, Castor and Pollux, which was originally performed in 1737. Castor is mortal, and Pollux is immortal. And the beginning of the opera, we find that Castor has been killed and sent to the underworld. Pollux returns home, to the woman he loves, Telemann, and when he tells her that Castor has been killed, she tells him that she only loves Castor and not Pollux, and asks him to go down to the underworld to retrieve Castor. Pollux is initially very hurt by this, but he decides to make the great brotherly sacrifice to go down to Hades and allow Castor to come up and be alive while he takes Castor's place in the underworld. the great head god Jupiter is so moved by this that he grants immortality to both brothers. This set of music shows the sentimentality that is portrayed in Castor and Pollux, from the minuets of the prologue to the lamenting music when we find out that Castor has died. There are dances of athletes, some passepieds, which are ethnic dances, finishing up with a fabulous round dance at the end. Sebastian Bach's masterpiece, the Orchestral Suite in D major. This is in five movements. It's an overture, an air, which I think many of you probably know as the air on a G string, followed by a gavotte, a bourré, and a lively jig. This is an incredible piece of music that Bach wrote for the Collegium Musicum of Leipzig, which was a group of musicians composed of both students and professional musicians who got together at Zimmermann's coffee house. In essence, this was like getting together at the bar to play contemporary music. They played music by Telemann, by Handel, and by Bach himself. And so this was one of the pieces that Bach wrote for that group, which he led in the middle part of the 18th century. It's important to note that Bach, in this program, is actually the hero of his son, Carl-Philippe Emanuel, who is the composer of the concerto on our program. We know that Bach was CPE's hero because CPE writes a glowing obituary upon Bach's death. And this piece itself, the D major suite, is actually in CPE Bach's hand. We have the music of this piece because Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach copied it out into manuscript. So very excited to see all of you at this program, and we hope you enjoy this concert.